In this Photoshop lesson, I'm going to show you how to remove your background in a matter of a second. We're going to use actions as the process. Once it's set up, you'll be able to remove your lines without even thinking about it. So let's get right into it. We have our sketch here, ready to go. First thing we want to do is go to Image, Adjustments, Levels. Once we click on this, we have our dialog box. We're going to select on the white eyedropper. We're going to take this white eyedropper and we're going to place it over the white background. We want to make sure we click, because what it's doing is setting the white point. It's removing any residual gray that's underneath that eyedropper. To the naked eye, we can't see it sometimes. This is why we want to go ahead and use the white eyedropper to set that point. Also, if you look at your black line, if you have ink, you will want to increase the black slider and slide it to the right to intensify that line to make sure that we get the black in there so it's not gray. If you look at the middle gray values or the marker, if you feel like they're going too dark, we can grab the gray slider, which represents the grays in our image. We can slide it to the left to make it lighter, or we can slide it to the right to go darker. So I might just open it up just a little bit by sliding it to the left. Click OK. Now, if there's any little bits around the image that you want to clean up, we can come over here to the Spot Healing Brush tool or Remove tool, and we can just go ahead and draw. Let me go ahead and grab my stylus. So I'm using a Wacom tablet, Cintiq, and so if there's any little bits and pieces that you want out of there, you can get it out. Right, so it's up to you, but I just want you to see exactly what I would do. Clean it up, make sure there's no little specks on your image. Now we're going to go ahead and set up our actions. So we want to go to our actions panel. If your actions panel is not on the right side here, we want to go up to Window, and we want to go to Actions. And this will bring it up or hide it. At this point, we will now set up a folder. It's going to be an action set that will allow us to store all of our illustrative actions that we will create. So I'm going to create a new set, and it's going to be called Illustration. Go ahead and click OK. And we're going to start our first action. So we're going to click on the new icon, the plus sign. This we will label. Let's pull this over here. Remove line. If you want, at this point, you can give this a keyboard shortcut. I'm not going to do that, but you have the option to do it now, and you can also do it later on. We will go ahead and hit record, and now we're ready to go. You know you're ready when the red button is activated. One important thing to remember, every single thing that you do at this point in Photoshop is now being recorded, every step. So if you Command Z, redo, anything that you do is going to be captured. So you want to be mindful of that and thoughtful when you're going through the process. But remember, later on, you can delete some of the steps out. So we'll talk about that. At this point, we want to go to Channels. Put your cursor right over the RGB icon. You're going to use Command or Control. Hold. You'll see a little selection box around the hand. That means it's going to allow you to make a selection. So go ahead and left click, and it becomes active. Now that your pixels are active, what is being activated? Whenever we select this, it's always going to make the lights, the highlights of the image are going to be the active images that come forward, and the dark lines are going to be left behind. What we want to do is invert this. So we're going to go to Select, Inverse. We're going to now go back to Layers. We're going to create a new layer, and we're going to fill with black. So what you can do is go over to your toolbar, click on the Reset to Default, And then, now that is active with black, you can fill, and the keyboard shortcut is Option or Alt, and you're gonna hit Backspace or Delete, depending if you're using Windows or Mac. So now that I just filled this in with black, we wanna deselect our line. So we go up to Select, Deselect. Now, if you look, the line is obviously going to look very heavy because we now just duplicated that line work on top of the layer underneath. So if I turn the layer off on the bottom, you can see that it's now extracted from the image. So I'm going to turn this back on. Now remember, with our actions, everything that we do is being recorded. So you can see that it just hit the background. And then it turned it back on. So I'm okay with this right now. That's not a big deal. It's not gonna affect the action for what we're doing, but we'll go ahead and continue. Now what I wanna do is create a new solid color layer so we can place this underneath so we can see what this looks like if we're on white. So we go to the adjustment layers, click, go solid color. We wanna make sure we're using pure white, then click okay. Now we're going to drag this underneath, and now we can see our sketch, what it would look like when it's placed underneath a solid color. At this point, we will go up to our actions, and we want to stop. Now that we create our action, we have to see if it works. We have to test it out. So let's just go ahead and undo everything that we just did. Okay, so I'm going to take this line, that line layer, and this solid here, make sure I have both of them. Let's go ahead and delete those out of there. Now we're back to the background. So what we want to do is go over to our actions palette, and you'll see there's the set. So if I highlight the set, you'll see the play button is not active. So the actual action is right here, remove line. When we close it, this is the action. We're gonna hit play and see what happens. And so now, if we go ahead and turn these off, you can see we have our line isolated. So there you have it. Now we have your action that you can use over and over again to remove your lines from your background sketches, from sketchbooks, from drawings that you do in a figure drawing class or whatever you're working on. It's gonna allow you to be able to pull it out and change the color of these lines. But before you go, in below, I have in the descriptions area, I have this action for you. And I have two additional actions that have slight variations on how to remove lines from ink, something similar to this, and a sketch. Very similar, but little bit different process. So in the meantime, keep painting, producing, deuces.